bottom line is that most RVers carry, but it's not a topic that you see a lot on YouTube. Why? Because a lot of YouTubers are afraid that if they broach the subject of guns, they'll get demonetized. We're not afraid.
No, I'd rather be judged by 12 than carried by 6. Welcome back to the RV Odd Couple. My name is John.
And I'm Mercedes. And long story short, we sold most of our possessions in pursuit of freedom, independence, and adventure.
Because life is so short, you guys.
It is. And okay, guys, if you're looking for a video where John and I agree on everything, you're going to have to keep waiting because this is a video where we have very differing opinions. So the reality is that I absolutely hate this topic. I did not want to broach this subject whatsoever. But there's two things that John told me that convinced me to jump on board. The first one was that we negotiated that next week's video, I get to choose the topic. So make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to next week's video.
You're unbelievable.
The second thing that John said, which I have to hand it to him, it is the truth, is he looked at me square in the eye and he said, okay, Mercedes, how many RVers have we met on the road that carry? And it's like too many to mention, right? And he's like, how many YouTube videos have you seen on the subject educating people about it?
Right.
And it's like, not nearly enough.
Right. And so in this video, we just want to share about our experience and some things that RVers should really, really consider if they're going to carry firearms and travel across state lines. Guys, I think this is such an important subject that not a lot of YouTubers touch because they're afraid that the YouTube is going to suppress the video, right?
Yeah.
We went down the rabbit hole today for about an hour and a half, making sure that we weren't going to break any of YouTube rules. We don't want to break YouTube rules,
no.
But we always want to educate our audience, our people on, you know,
the realities
of RV life. And if you can't tell, the world is becoming more and more dangerous.
Yeah.
I believe that everyone should carry a firearm with them. And I also believe that you should also take the necessary steps, do the necessary homework to make sure that you're doing it legally and that you're getting properly trained.
I agree with the legally and properly trained. I think some people shouldn't carry firearms, and that's okay. I really think that you need to thine own self be true. But our goal here is just to lay out the realities and you can make the best choice for you and your family. Yeah.
We are not professional firearms people.
Nope.
We're not teaching anyone how to use a firearm. It's not our job. It's not what we do. We're not showing you how to make ammunition.
We're not selling
any firearms or ammunition. All we're doing is sharing our experience in this video and why we think it's so important that RVers have a means to protect themselves. And the reason why is because you're your best line of defense and you should be ready to defend yourself and your family at all times.
Yeah, I mean, this is one of the realities of RVing is that when you're traveling to different cities and different locations, you don't know if you're in a good part of town or a bad part of town. The line between the good side of the tracks and the bad side of the tracks is really thin.
You don't know where it is.
You have no idea. Heavy populated cities are like not exactly the safest, right? I mean, there's some really good areas of town and in big cities. I'm not trying to condemn all big cities, but like there's more types of crime and stuff like that. On the flip side, when you're in a remote location, it can take a really long time for the authorities to get you.
Hours.
In a remote place and being in a city has its pros and cons as well.
Every RVer out there should have some type of a defense system that they're comfortable with.
Yeah.
Right. And so I think that every RVer should carry a gun if they're allowed to do so legally. Now, with that said, you should be properly trained. You should get properly licensed.
Yeah.
Shouldn't break any laws.
And I disagree with that. I don't necessarily think firearms are for everyone. And that's okay. You know, like we have a good friend, Kim. She talks about if she had a firearm, the assailant would take it from her and use it against her.
Right.
And
which
so
is serious consideration.
Yeah. And so if you don't feel comfortable with the firearm, I think that that's, you know, we're not trying to tell you what to choose. I think it's about giving you all the information so you can make the best choices for yourself and your family. I mean, because we're total opposites, right? John would like to mount the firearms on the walls and use them as RV decor.
No, and that's not our, it's I don't want totally that as RV decor. It's when you're considering where to hide your weapons. We have a kid in the house. Okay, and so if I put them up and lock them high, Sage couldn't possibly get at those.
Yeah, I'm not.
That's the only reason I asked you if I could do that. It wasn't to put my firearms on the wall. It's safe storage to keep them away from Sage.
Yeah, I think it was totally decor.
Not true.
It was totally a decor. So everyone has their different preferences, right? But as far as RVing goes, it's really going to depend on which states you're traveling, even which counties and cities you're traveling through. So don't just assume that, like, because in one state this is okay to travel with your firearm like this, that it's in another. Or don't just assume that because you have a concealed carry that it works in every single state, because they don't. So we all have a responsibility. If we are going to take on this, which is our right, if we are going to take that on, then you have a really strong responsibility to find out as much as you can about it. But as RVers specifically, there's certain nuances you need to know about. Like, for example, if you're in a motorhome versus if you're in a travel trailer or a towable, it's a totally different dynamic.
Well, depending on the states, guys.
Yes.
And every state has its own rules, how to transport them, how you can carry them, where you can carry them.
It's tricky. And here's what I want to point out with the motorhome versus the towable. So with the motorhome, you can walk through the cockpit all the way to the back of the motorhome. Usually it's like all one vehicle, one vessel, right? With the towable, be it a fifth wheel, be it a travel trailer, you have to like get out of the truck.
You'd stop, and then walk back, get in, and then have to get into a concealed location. Some states actually want you to lock up both the firearm and the ammunition separately.
Yeah, which is, so I mean, there's a lot of stuff you guys have to look into here. And it's really important not to skimp on this, especially if it's just the two of you traveling or if you have kids. But with kids, you have another danger, because you don't just have to protect against the outside world. You have to protect the insiders as well.
And so this is something that scares me every single day, you guys.
Yeah.
Is Sage getting into my places. So I have an extremely high responsibility.
Yeah.
To make sure that Sage can never access my firearms. And if she did, she could never possibly pull the trigger
or fire
the firearm.
Yeah.
And so I've taken great care. And I think about this every day, because I have firearms in every vehicle I have. I have multiple firearms. Yeah. I have pistols. I have a shotgun. I've got rifles.
Octopus. It's no, like you only have one hand.
No, well, that's not true. But I just have them in certain locations. And I plan out whenever I go anywhere.
Yeah.
The first thing I do when I get to a site is I scope it out. I scope out who my neighbors are. I try to get to know who my neighbors are. I try to get a phone number if I possibly can. One of the first questions I asked somebody that just pulled in here, do you carry?
Yeah.
And the answer was yes.
Yeah.
And we made a plan, right? Because we are where we are. And if anything goes wrong, I know there's somebody next to me that can help protect me and my family as well as myself.
Yeah, and likewise. And I think no matter whether you have a firearm or not, especially if you don't have a firearm, you need to have a plan when you scope out an RV park. Like, we like RV parks that have gates, you know?
Security.
Yeah, but even some of the gates that we see are really just like a little aluminum pole that you could totally easily get through if you really wanted to. So really, your safety and your security is incumbent upon yourself.
Right.
You can't put that on anyone else's shoulders. It's square on your shoulders.
Yeah, and like Mercedes was talking about earlier, depending on the state that you're in, there's going to be all kinds of different rules for different states where you are RVing, how you transport, where you carry them, how you can carry them. I've got a certain protocol that I use, and I've got to pay close attention to where they are. When I travel, it's always within reach. My firearm is always within reach.
Yeah. Which, I mean, is good, because if you, heaven forbid, you need it accessible, but it also carries with it a certain amount of danger as well, having it so near to you. Heaven forbid the wrong person sees it, they assume something they shouldn't assume. You just have to be so careful in either direction. Whether you have them, you have to be careful, and if you don't have them, you have to be extra careful as well.
So I went ahead and got licensed in my home state of Florida. I got my concealed carry. I'm also very aware of which states reciprocate with Florida, and currently there's 38 states that reciprocate for Florida. They honor my license in Florida. I've got to be super careful cross into a state. Typically, they're blue states.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I believe that everyone in this country right now who carries a firearm should carry insurance, because you could be locked up for a very long time while they try to figure out if you had the right to do what you did.
But like we said earlier, there's a lot of people out there that should not be carrying firearms. And it shouldn't. Firearms are not the first line of defense. They're like the last line of defense. There's so many other things, preventative measures that you can take that will keep you, hopefully, from even having to ever pull out your firearm.
Right. And the reason most people won't carry a firearm is quite frankly, they're afraid of firearms. Guys, there is so much training out there nowadays. And if you're uncomfortable with it, Mercedes was terrified of a firearm.
Oh my gosh.
But before I would marry her, believe it or not, this is a true story, I made her go to a firearm firing range, and actually I bought her a new Ruger 9, and I made her fire the weapon, and it was a nightmare.
It was horrible.
It was worse than when I was trying to train her how to drive, guys.
The RV,
because
yeah.
the whole firing lanes were full, about 25 lanes, and every time she was shaking more than she was holding the trigger.
It was terrifying.
I had to step back and let somebody
else.
Because
he's the worst teacher ever.
I'm not a good. I'm. I guess I'm not a very good teacher
he's
with
not,
my wife, but I've trained
not.
My kids how to shoot. They all not. All my children know how to shoot.
Yeah.
Bottom line is,
and
I had
to.
Bottom line is I had to pay somebody to train Mercedes because I just couldn't do
it.
No,
it's true. He did have to slip the guy a bill to like, and you know what? That's another thing too. When you are going to do the training, be true to yourself. Like, he should not be teaching me how to do anything, because when he tells me what to do, I'm like, don't tell me how to live my life, you know? So he's have a professional teach you. So to be fair, this was the first time I had ever fired a firearm, and I envisioned my first time firing a firearm being like in an open field that was calm and like serene, you know, like cowboy era-esque. And instead it was like boom, boom, bam, boom, 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 bam. And nobody warned me that when you fire, half of the bullet flies back at you.
It's called the shell.
It was terrifying, but it flies back at you, and then everyone's casings are all flying, because I assumed the whole bullet went forward, and that's not what happened.
The day I took her out to fire her first weapon, the whole firing range, it was 24 lanes, and all
everyone
of them were filled.
Everyone in town was there.
And so she was shaking, just
it
shaking,
was
shaking,
horrible.
Shaking. And I was trying to keep her calm and talk to her. And every time somebody would fire, she'd jump.
Yeah, and every time I would do that, he'd be like, no, don't do that. Yeah. You're gonna. It was just not
so good. Great tip. If you
don't,
you know,
teach your wife how to
don't
fire
teach your
a
wife.
Firearm.
Yeah, send it to a professional to do it. That's what we ended up doing. I paid somebody else to train Mercedes how to fire a weapon, and she knows how to do it very well now.
Hire that out.
So we carry two types of insurance, because we do carry firearms. The two insurance we carry is what? USCCA. We carry a policy with them, both Mercedes and I,
and
the
Law
other one
Shield.
Is, and we carry Law Shield.
Yeah.
And this is just in case we are ever forced to discharge our firearms in protection of our life or security.
Heaven forbid.
Someone will come in to represent us and hopefully get us out of jail as soon as they possibly can.
Yeah.
Now, I really do believe that if you can legally carry a gun, you should carry a gun. Mercedes and I just disagree, and that's fine.
Yeah.
But I think you have a responsibility to yourself and your family, and I also think you even have a responsibility to your neighbors, you know, as RVers. But some people just don't get it. They don't want to carry a gun.
Yeah.
Everyone should take great care of where they store their firearms, how they store their firearms, and how they move their firearms from one vehicle to another. So I have handguns, I have shotguns, I have rifles. But I would suggest if someone was to pick one gun to defend your RV and your family, it would be a shotgun, guys. And typically, you don't even need to get licensed to carry a shotgun inside your RV.
So, guys, for those of you that are like, no, I really shouldn't be carrying a firearm, there's other ways to defend yourself. I mean, bear spray, wasp spray, it has a very direct
stun guns.
Spray. Yeah, so there's other things.
Knives.
You know.
There's a lot of different ways to defend yourself. Mercedes had a bat.
Yes.
She used to have a bat in her apartment when I first went over to visit her many, many years ago, 13 years ago now. And I asked Mercedes, how do you protect yourself being in this part of the neighborhood, in this apartment here? And she pulled out this small bat that was about,
was
I don't know, 20
small.
Inches.
And my bat was not small.
It was a small bat.
It was a large bat. Okay, people, it was huge.
And one of the problems with that type of a weapon is that you got to get in close range to hit somebody.
And
with
I agree
it.
With that.
It's a big problem.
That's a last resort kind of like thing. That's not going to protect you. That's why the wasp spray and the bear spray is awesome, because you can get them from far away. You don't want to be really close with the people.
But there are firearms that you can carry with you that you don't need a license for. Typically, when it comes to handguns, you will need a license for a handgun. So look into your home state rules and regulations. Do the necessary homework to do everything legally. Get the proper training and take the proper safety courses so that not only, you know, that you can protect yourself, but that you're not going to hurt yourself or hurt your family because you haven't had the proper training.
Yeah.
You know, just like anything else in life, practice, practice, practice.
So remember, guys, next week I get to choose the video and it's going to be absolutely amazing. So make sure that you're subscribed and I'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, bottom line is that most RVers carry, but it's a subject that you don't see on YouTube because most YouTubers are afraid to talk about guns because they're afraid they'll get demonetized.
But I'd rather be carried by six than
No, don't.
Okay, do it again.